guys, this is part two. I am not sure what where the first video ended. Goodness gracious. But anyways, I am into getting ready to ice the second layer. So just in case you didn't see, here is the beautiful first layer that has been iced. It's gorgeous. It looks very professional, very bakery-like. I have my favorite cuppa too, by the way. I forgot to mention that earlier. I've been so, like, crazy with ideas lately. I have been doing videos, I think, and I've been forgetting to mention to grab your favorite cuppa. But you know what, you guys, those of you that follow me know to do that, right? It's coffee right now. All right, so I'm ready for my second layer, which is here. And see how this one has a little hole in it? That is okay. It's not going to matter because that is going to be where I will fill the center with the beautiful decor that I am going to... I changed my mind. Add to it. No. No, that's right. Yeah. So here's what's very, very cool about this. You have a flat piece right here, and then that sits perfectly on top of your first layer of iced cake. Okay, yeah, I know what I'm talking about. All right, so now you would use the rest of your icing, and you just pile it on and start your spreading. And I cannot wait to present this cake to my mother-in-law today. She is 92 years old today. 92 years young, you guys. And we're going to take her out to eat. And we have the family in today. So it's all that she loves. Everything that she loves, she's getting today. She's getting all of her wishes to come true today. So, I think what I'm going to do is work on finishing up this cake, and then when I'm done with that, then I just need to get those gifts wrapped up for her. And like I said, I don't know if you heard what I was saying in the last video, because I don't know where it shut off. I was putting all of my focus on this cake, but if anybody is interested in having me do a tutorial, I am considering getting some of my tutorials up as classes. As I said in the first video, and if you caught it, I'm not sure, I do art and music for a living. YouTube doesn't really pay my bills, so if anybody is interested in the tutorials, then I would be more than happy to do the tutorials for you within a classroom setting online.